abandoned homes that neighbors say lead to crime and violence. Pittsburgh depends on its Red Up crews to clean up troubled neighborhoods, demolishing old buildings. But a new report obtained by Channel 4 Action News shows that the communities needing the most attention are being bypassed. Channel 4 Action News reporter Sheldon Ingram with a closer look tonight.
This weed-infested property sits in the city's Carrick neighborhood, one of the neighborhoods receiving the least amount of service from Red Up crews. So the question is, how does Public Works determine which neighborhoods receive first priority? Abandoned properties like this exist throughout the city, but the city controller's audit says only one neighborhood received the bulk of the cleanup by Red Up crews in 2008 and 2009. Controller Mike Lamb says his numbers show that the north side received 41% of Red Up services during the two-year span, which happens to be where the mayor lived during that time. Another 37% was divided among other neighborhoods, with Carrick, Knoxville, Beachview, Brookline, and other neighborhoods in the south receiving the least Red Up services while logging the most requests. The city's public works director says those neighborhoods actually received priority when Red Up crews first came on board.
In the inception of Red Up, there was a lot of time spent in different neighborhoods such as Beltsuver, Knoxville, and Allentown. Those were areas we focused on to begin with.
06 and 07?
I believe 06, 07 were areas that we really focused on.
But critics in Carrick and Brookline say Red Up is lacking a uniform system to evenly distribute services.
I mean, I think at the end of the day, we need to know what criteria is being used by the Red Up crew when they go out and they clean up different lots. I've never actually seen that criteria.
To my knowledge, there is no system.
And that's what's frustrating.
It is frustrating to a number of our residents here.
We have Red Up as for public safety. That's first and foremost. If there's a situation that calls Red Up to go in and assist the maintenance division and for a public safety issue, then we go in and address it. Second is the magnitude of the cleanup.
The current Red Up system still does not pass the scrutiny of the city controller and city residents. Changing the system will still be their priority. In Carrick, Sheldon Ingram, Channel 4 Action News.